Hey guys, and welcome to another video of The Guide, our tutorial series on FIFA 19. I'm Benjamin, also known as Tess, and today I want to introduce you to another very fundamental concept of playing FIFA. And this time it's about how you should think as a FIFA player. And to be more precisely, it's about how you should evaluate your options to find solutions for situations. And this is all the time during the game, in the defense and also in the offense. And I think every FIFA player is already doing it to some extent, but you should do it all the time. This is the approach how you should play FIFA, because this is how you can improve as a FIFA player. Everything that we are going to upload on this channel is either a way to have a new option available as a solution to a certain situation, or to perform a solution in a better way, in a more successful way. But it's always about your options, and you have to think about this in game to take the best out of these videos and to improve your game. That's why this is another key concept and approach to the game, because it's an action all the time. This approach is very aligned on the understanding of the importance of ball contact in FIFA, because the evaluation of your options evolve around the time point when the player is having the ball contact. And we have a dedicated video about this where we explain this concept, and it's highly recommended to watch this video before. And you can click on it right now at the top right corner, or you can find the link to this video in the video description. And now let's start with the explanation of the concept about evaluating your options. So let's start by explaining the concept, and for this I'm going to show you a scene and I will demonstrate how I think as a FIFA player, how I scan the situation, evaluate my options and then proceed with an action. So let's start. My opponent is playing a long ball and I have to decide how I deal with it. I can accept the ball, but that's very risky because I can then immediately lose the ball. So I decide to head the ball, and now I have to think in what kind of direction do I head the ball. I could head it to my goalkeeper, but that's always a little bit risky. And my teammates around me are very close by, so I decide to head the ball to my left back because he's really uncovered. Now, before I accept the ball with my left back, I have to decide how I want to proceed, so I scan the situation. I could either accept the ball and start to dribble in various directions. Some of them are worse and some of them are better choices. Depending on the direction, I can also think about a pass to a teammate. For this, I start to look at my teammates and think about how I could pass to them and how likely the pass is to succeed. I could also play a one-touch pass, but I don't really like that because these passes are a little bit less accurate, as explained in the passing basic tutorial. And there's also no need to take this risk because I don't have immediate pressure for my opponent. So now I think about my passing options, and I don't really like the options which are right in front of me because there's always an opponent nearby to my teammate. But by looking at the radar, I can see that my winger is pretty open, so I decide to pass to him. And for this, I accept the ball in direction so that I'm able to play this pass right after with a very good setup. Now before accepting the ball, I have to do it all over again. Scan the situation and evaluate the options. In this case, I could also play a one-touch pass, but I don't really like it, so I continue by accepting the ball in that direction. After doing that, I have to decide how to continue with the next ball contact. I could play a pass to one of my teammates, but I don't really like that because one of the passes is easy to intercept for my opponent and the other one is also quite obvious. So I decide to start to dribble straight ahead to surprise my opponent a little bit and see how he reacts to it. If he's going to start to pressure me, I could still probably pass to my teammate to the side. And as you can see, my opponent anticipated the pass to the midfielder, so starting to dribble in that direction was a good idea. After accelerating, I have to decide for the next ball contact, as always, how do I continue? Do I play a pass to one of my teammates, or do I continue to dribble straight ahead, or do I change direction because I'm afraid that the opponent is able to tackle the ball or to put pressure on me? As the passes to the teammates are not really an option, I decide to continue dribble with full pace. And after taking this contact, I have to decide with the next contact, how do I continue? Do I play now the pass or do I continue with the dribbling? And in this case, now the pass to my teammate is an option, but I had the feeling that I can continue dribbling in that direction because my opponent is not really able to catch up. And now by taking several ball contacts in full pace dribbling, I'm in a much better position as you can see. I have a lot of space in front of me and I could continue dribble straight ahead in full pace. But now I think that the pass into the middle is very easy to play and I think it's the most dangerous option at the moment. I play the pass and now before accepting the ball, as you might already guessed, I have to think about what do I do now. Do I accept the ball and what kind of direction, or do I play a pass? So there are different options here available. I could accept the ball in that direction and could see if I'm able to pass back the ball to my winger, or I could accept it in that direction and try to play the pass to my other striker. I thought that the pass to my teammate here is quite obvious and that my opponent is maybe anticipating that, so I decided to accept the ball in that direction with a fake shot so that I'm able to continue to the opponent's goal with a lot of pace. And as you can see, the opponent anticipated the pass to the teammate, so I was able to outmove my opponent by this. I continue with another dribbling ball contact in full pace, and now I have to decide again, what do I do now? I could continue dribbling in the direction of the opponent's goal, or I could try to play a pass to my striker. And now I try to anticipate what my opponent is going to do. And if he is continuing to run in that direction, he can still cover both options quite good, but he can't cover the run of my striker into the box, so that's why I decided to play a cross onto my striker. Okay, wow, this was a lot to cover. And I made this example not to show the specific decisions that I took here. For example, that I did a fake shot or when to play the pass or when not to. These are concepts and techniques that we are going to explain in dedicated videos. It's about that you understand how you should think as a FIFA player and when you should think about it. So the time point for this evaluation is before you accept the ball or before every ball contact. I also wanted to demonstrate what the thoughts are when you evaluate a situation. So for example, what are my options and what options can my opponent influence, and from that infer what kind of action he is going to take most likely. Also, what do I gain by a certain action and what do I risk? You can't thoroughly evaluate every possibility, but the more you do it and think about it, the better you get at this. This is what the best FIFA players in the world separate them from the rest. The capability to do this with having a genuine idea what the best solution is. And you're not only doing this when you're attacking, but also when you're in the defense. But then you have to think more about the options that your opponent has. So let's take a look. My opponent has a free kick, and immediately after I think about to what teammate is he passing to. And in this case, I thought he's going to do a pass to his left back. So that's why I immediately start running with my striker to his left back. So now before he's accepting the ball, he has to think about what are his options. And he has basically three. He can pass back to his center back, he can pass to one of the teammates here, or he can accept the ball and start to dribble in that direction. And I thought because of my run towards him, he's not going to play this pass and he's more likely to pass back. So that's why I changed my run to intercept this pass. Well, that didn't work out, but that's okay. Now my opponent has to think about how does he continue. Does he keep dribbling straight ahead or does he play a pass to one of his teammates? And for most of the options, I can do much with my striker. So that's why I have to do a player switch. And I think that the pass to his teammate here is more likely, and that's why I switched the player and then tried to intercept the pass. This time I was right, but I didn't get the ball. And my opponent was afraid of losing the ball, so that's why he played a one-touch pass. When his player is receiving the ball, I switched to the closest defender and immediately tackle to have maybe a chance to get to the ball. But that wasn't the best decision, as you can see. That's why I immediately switched the player after the tackle, because the defender who did the tackle can't act properly for a few seconds now. But then I realized, what are the options for my opponent can continue? He can either accept the ball in that direction and continue to dribble, or he can play a through pass to his left back. And for these two options of my opponent, my right back, the defender who did the tackle, is the best player to have an influence on. So that's why I switch back to him and start to cover the open space. Now it's the same for my opponent. Before accepting the ball, he has to make a decision how he wants to continue. Does he want to get to the wing, or does he want to play a pass into the middle? And I think that the passing options are not very good at the moment, so I think that he's going to continue to the wing, and that's why I keep running back. I was right with my assumption and he continued dribbling on the wing, and now, as always, with the next ball contact, he has to make another decision. And from my point of view, not much has changed for him, so that's why I thought he's going to continue dribbling on the wing. And as you can see, he surprised me with that shot fake to stop. And now, because my right back is a little bit out of position, I have to do a player switch. And for that, I have to think about what are the options for my opponent, how does he continue. And it's most likely that he's going to start to dribble in that direction, or he's going to play a pass to one of his teammates here, because the other ones are offset at the moment. But it's clear that Nainggolan, my midfielder here, has the best chances to disturb the options of my opponent, so that's why I want to switch to him. I do an error at the player switching with the right stick, but I correct it right after. So now my opponent is receiving the ball and he has to make another decision. And basically there are three options. He can play a pass to this player, or he can maybe just stop here. And now you have to get in the head of your opponent. Because I'm running back with my midfielder at the moment, it looks like I'm going to intercept the pass to this teammate. So that's why I change my direction to intercept the pass to the other one. It works, I get into the passing lane, get contact to the ball, but in the end I wasn't really able to get ball possession. So as you can see, it's a little bit different when you're defending. You think about what are the options that your opponent has and how you can disturb it in the most successful way. We like to say that FIFA is somewhat like fast-paced chess. All the time you have to think about your options and what the best solution is for a certain situation. This video should have raised awareness about this and also taught you when to think about it and how to think about it. As mentioned earlier, all the videos on this channel will then provide you either a new option to a certain situation or a way to perform an option in a more successful way. That's why it's so important to understand how you have to think during the game, because then you will be able to understand the reasoning for all the other concepts. This was another video with a very fundamental concept and a little bit different approach because we didn't explain a certain technique, for example how to defend or pass, etc. Was this still helpful for you? Please leave feedback in the comment section below, and if you liked it, please leave a thumbs up. Also make sure to subscribe to this channel and activate the bell to not miss any of the upcoming videos. Check out the video description for more videos of the guide and information about our private coaching offers with elite and top 100 players. Thanks for your attention, keep a clean sheet, I'm out.